All right, guys, the arms everyday experiment is officially over, and I will never be training my arms every single day again, and I'm gonna tell you exactly why. When I first started making videos for the wonderful people of the internet, I got a lot of hateful comments about having small arms. So what did I do? I started training my arms more. I started training them harder. I stumbled across something on the internet called nuclei overload training. Megan over at Team 3D Alpha was the first person to bring this concept to YouTube, but it was being discussed in bodybuilding forums well before he brought it up on YouTube. I became obsessed with the concept of nuclei overload because it basically means that you train a muscle group every single day, you increase the nuclei in the muscle cell, and it increases the potential for growth. So it seemed like a really fair value proposition to me. My first overtraining experiment, my arms started off at 16.8 inches, and this is after years of training. Now, I did like 100 curls every single day, and my arms went from 16.8 to 17.2 inches, and I documented this for you guys on a YouTube channel, and you can see that video. I'll throw it down in the description below. After the experiment, I go back to my normal arm training, and the gains kind of slow down. So then, I come across a gentleman called Rich Piana. Rest in peace to Rich Piana. And he had this concept called feeder workouts. Now, feeder workouts, very similar to nuclei overload, but feeder workouts are when you train a muscle group right before you go to bed, but you're doing like 50 to 100 rep sets of both biceps and triceps. Now, when I first heard about feeder workouts and how Rich Piana described how they worked, I thought it was crazy, but I also thought it was kind of genius. So what did I do? I tried the feeder workout experiment last year on the channel. So my arms grow from 17.5 to 17.75 inches. And over the course of the next 2 months, I actually got my arms to the biggest they have ever been. 18 total inches. Took me years of overtraining to finally get my arms to 18 inches. Now recently after dieting, my arms got all the way down to 17.5 inches. So I decided while I'm on my shred, I'm gonna try one more overtraining experiment to see if I could grow my arms even in a calorie deficit. Now, in just 2 weeks of the recent experiment, my arms went from 17.5 to 17.75 inches. And I documented that on the very last video in the series. Now, since the last video, I decided that training your arms every single day is pretty much a waste of time and dumb, and you do not need to do it to see really fast results. A lot of people comment when I do these overtraining videos, they're saying you're gonna tear a muscle and you're gonna have this crazy, tragic, like bicep tear, and you're just gonna like blow the bicep off your bone. No, that did not happen, and that's not why I will never be training a muscle group every single day again. The number one reason why I will never do this experiment again is the reason why all these overtraining experiments work every single time I have done them is because I have increased my volume. Increasing your volume is the guaranteed path to pass the plateau. Just think about this logically. If you go from doing 5 to 10 sets of arms to 30 to 40 sets of arms, you're going to blow up your gains. You don't need to do a set every single day. You don't need to say do 5, 10 sets every single day. You could say do 30, 40 sets and increase your volume, training arms 3 to 4 times a week. Of course, you're just doing more total sets in that time frame. I just came to this realization because there's so many incredible volume studies on the internet. In fact, I will throw all the research studies and all these science-backed studies down in the description below, but there is one study that took a group of trained lifters. One group did 9 sets, one group did 27 sets, and one group did 45 sets. Now, guess which group blew away the other two groups in terms of muscle growth? The group that did 45 total sets per week. Now, they didn't train a muscle group every single day, but they did a ton of volume over the course of a week. So you don't need to train a muscle group every single day to see the fastest growth possible. What you need to do is simply increase your training volume. And that is why all of my overtraining experiments have worked. So the punchline of this video is gym bros who do more sets, get more gains, but never sacrifice quality and intensity over just trying to hit that magical number of hitting a muscle group every single day. So if your arms are lagging, or really any muscle group is lagging, don't be an internet troll and accuse everyone with a tan and a pump of being on steroids. Just work harder and do more sets, and I guarantee you, you are going to blow up those gains. So that is all I have for you guys today. Oh,
ain't got no gains. You ain't lift no weights.